What's up?
We are here today because we are going to teach you how to do Disney on a budget, college style.
Yeah, we took a poll a couple days ago, and that's what you guys said that you wanted to hear the most about. So we've compiled a list of our personal tips and tricks from our Disney experiences to let you guys know how to get the most bang for your buck.
And meet our chickens. It's almost Easter! So we put out baby chickens.
Moving on.
Are you ready?
Are you ready?
These are in whatsoever no order
to
how it will save you money or how well it will work. This is purely based off of your preference of what you think with your family size, how much your budget is.
What you're looking to do a lot as well.
So,
how long your stay is, etc.
You do you.
You take...
But take the tips.
The advice, and you go from there. Third party source.
Here is Danielle with the weather. Here is...
and now the weather.
Here is Danielle with our first and starting off tip.
Well, I figure, the first thing that you're going to want to figure out when you're planning your Disney vacation is actually planning your Disney vacation. And when I say planning, I mean buying your tickets, picking your dates, making your resort reservations, whether or not you're staying on or off Disney property.
But we'll talk about that later.
Booking your flight or driving, you know, that kind of thing. So, first of all, I would say our most number one tip. Good English
there. Our number one tip is...
Our number one tip about tickets would be to buy your tickets from a third-party provider. Say, AAA or another travel association. If you can find one that's fee-free, that would save you even more in the long run. But most of the time, if you buy your tickets from a third-party provider, you're going to get a discount off of the usual Disney price if you buy your tickets from the Disney website. I think somewhere said it was anywhere from 5 to 20%, but don't quote me on that. For instance, I use AAA because my dad is a AAA member, and I saved probably about $80 on this upcoming ticket.
So tell me how many tickets you bought and how much it was. Rough estimate. Through AAA.
Through AAA.
And then I will tell you how much mine were with an annual pass.
Okay, through AAA, it also depends on how long you're going for too, because...
And water parks and more.
Yeah, exactly.
And park hopper. But we're just gonna throw in that Danielle got park hopper and no water parks.
Yeah, for this trip. For this trip. This trip, we did a six-day trip.
Six days park hopper.
And it cost me around $450.
So. Whereas, we can kind of transition into my first tip from there, because dependent upon how much you go to Disney, say I go 2 to 3 times a year, so it would be so worth it to buy the annual pass. So I mean, it depended upon how much your family is gonna go.
Why not? Especially if you live local, if you live around.
If you Orlando. If you live in Florida. It's only $200.
Yeah,
because
it
gives you a checked box to say I am a Florida resident, whereas I am in Ohio. So I think I paid for my annual pass, for park hopper, for
water parks, Memory Maker.
It also includes Memory Maker. It includes free parking. I paid $749, and I've definitely got my worth of it because. I mean, she's going for 6 days.
Yeah.
And it was 400 and something.
And also, you have a DVC discount too, so it might be a little more expensive without the Disney Vacation Club member
discount. Yes, I did put in my parents' DVC membership discount, and I got a little more off of that. I don't know if most people watching this are DVC members, but if your family loves Disney and you want a timeshare there, Disney Vacation Club is a way to go. Disney Vacation Club has saved my family so much money in hotels, in discounts, in special events. There's DVC parties, there's annual pass member parties. There's just so much more it has to offer you if you and your family or you and your best friend
go multiple times a year.
This will be my third time using my annual pass since I went twice last summer, and I went for however many. We probably went 6 or 7 days the first time, and I went 6 or 7 days the second time. So that's 14 days for $749, adding on the 6 days we're doing in May, which will still count. So
it's a good idea.
21 days yeah. for $700 and some odd dollars.
For sure. It'll save you a lot. Another tip that we have when it comes to planning your vacation. First of all, I mean, I think that this would be a no-brainer, but try to save before you go. Right now, I literally have a, well, if you guys remember from our Beauty and the Beast video, when I bought that popcorn bucket, it is now my change bucket for Disney. So every time I find change, I'm throwing it in there. And before we go, we're going to run to Walmart and throw it in the changer over thingy that makes your coins dollars.
I also have a fishbowl in my room full of change.
Another thing to consider when planning your vacation is if you can and it doesn't interfere with like your, if you have children, their school year or other kind of things like that.
Just take them out. Just take them out.
Try to go during the cheaper times of the year because at Disney there are peak times. Like the beginning of summer is like one of the peak times, which is great because that's when we're going, so it's the most expensive.
We can, like, I'll insert here, they have a calendar. Like, sometimes they're called magic periods and sometimes they're holiday periods, whereas in like the extra magic periods would be summertime, which is when it's most crowded, which is when you could take your kids.
Yeah.
But
which is why it's a peak time and it's more expensive. If you go during the off-peak months, like in wintertime, early spring.
February is actually, I read, the least populated month.
January, February, March would probably be a great idea. You can go around the holidays, but if it's going to be a lot more crowded than it is during the rest of the
winter. We just went in 2015.
In December.
And it was packed.
It was crazy.
It's also a lot cooler if you would take
That's
a
true.
Trip in February. Yeah. Your kids won't die of heat stroke.
Another tip when it comes to planning, so pre-vacation, is to buy things that you might need before you go. You'd think that that would be a no-brainer, but especially if you're not used to the Florida weather and how it is, one thing that I would recommend wholly that you buy beforehand is ponchos.
It rains every single day you're at the parks. Guaranteed.
Probably
or
for like
every
half
other
an
least.
Hour to an hour, especially if you go in the summertime like we do.
Florida always has an afternoon storm, every time. But don't let it ruin your fun. Don't leave the park. Some will clear out and the lines will shorten, but you stay.
And it's worth it if you have a poncho because then you can stay at least relatively dry and like
Plus
we said.
Plus they're good for water rides.
Absolutely.
Wear it on Splash Mountain.
And Pirates of the Caribbean. Other stuff to take into consideration, if you're into pin trading, you can get a lot of Disney pins on eBay for a dollar or two compared to 8 to 20 bucks at the parks. So if you're into that, that's something to look into. Also, some other Disney experiences that people really like to do is the autograph book. So get autographs from character meetups around the parks, and buying an autograph book on property is gonna run you, what, probably like 20 bucks?
When I was a kid, my parents splurged and bought the autograph book, but honestly, I wouldn't even have cared because I was so into the characters more than anything. But they're expensive, and they always come with the cool Mickey pen with the little Mickey head on the top.
So
and you always have to splurge for that, and I know those are like $3.99. Like, they're expensive pens. Like, go get a pack at the dollar store. Go make your own book. They have little Mickey book stuffs.
Yeah. You know, you can make your own cute little custom book, and then your kid's book will be way better than the other kid's.
But Chase Bank offers Disney credit card and Disney visas, where if you purchase things, like purchase different things at the parks, purchase some of your Disney vacation, on the card you will get Disney reward points, and you can spend those points in the parks, on your next vacation, in the gift shops, everywhere. So I've racked up a lot of points using my Disney Visa.
And also to add on to that, I know now, I can't
remember
where,
to go with that.
Where it is exactly. It might be Magic Kingdom?
I think all of them I've been to have been in Epcot, where they offer little special events for those with a Disney Visa. I got into
You don't even have to
Chase
have a Disney
Lounge.
Visa. You can just have like a Chase card.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's how I got into a special character meet, which was Minnie. It's like a special dressed up Minnie just for that occasion. So that's just another picture that we've gotten on our vacations. If you have a DVC card, if you have your annual pass holder card, or a Chase Visa, you can use those in the parks to get 10 to 15% off your purchases. So you'll go to purchase it and you'll be like, hey, I am a DVC, I'm an annual pass member, yada yada, and they will give you that money off, which is a way that I save money on my purchases.
Some other stuff to think about in planning your trip. There are a lot of opportunities to save money before you even go, just to think about some stuff before you leave. Another thing when it comes to like the logistics of planning your trip, take your time to find a cheap flight, because there are cheap flights out there, and there are even cheap flights that are like non-stop that will take you straight to Orlando.
We always do non-stop. My mom gets freaked out that we stop.
And every single time that we've flown, we've taken Southwest. So I mean, it could be different in your area.
Allegiance and Southwest.
It could be different in your area depending on what's cheaper from your airport, but that's just where we are. That's one of the cheapest options for us. Or even, you don't even have to fly, you can drive, and that could save you a lot of money in the long run.
If we could.
But if you do choose to drive, know that you're in for a long haul. We're about 15-16 hours from Disney, where we are right now, and we've driven twice.
It's the most horrid drive. I have now driven blah, 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 blah.
Three times.
I have now driven three times, and every time I get out of that car, I'm probably homicidal.
I remember every time we hit Georgia, she's like, I literally want to rip my face off right now.
I literally want to smack my face on the car door.
She said that before.
It's the worst drive. But if you drive, you can take a lot more stuff with you because you don't have to weigh your suitcases at the airport. You can bring stuff home that you regularly wouldn't bring home. Like, Danielle really wants to buy a plant that we can't bring home on a plane.
I know, it's the Flower and Garden Festival, and I just want to buy succulents. Birthdays, Christmases, Valentine's Day, Easter. If you're getting a gift, tell people to get you Disney gift cards. It's a really,
or just cash.
Or cash, yeah. It's a really good...
Put it in the fishbowl.
It's a really good way to save money, and when you bring all those gift cards to the parks, it can go for anything. It can go for food, it can go for merchandise, it can go for whatever you want it to go for. And those things add up after a while, too.
I think we had $250 worth of Disney gift cards that my mom gave us last time. I think it was like $250. Pretty expensive. I think with my mom's and combined with my own that I'd gotten, and I paid for us to eat. Like, we just used them for food instead of me buying stuff that I didn't need with them. We used it on food, and we almost lasted the whole time on those gift cards and used our money to buy other things instead.
So it's a really good way to save money, and that's what this whole video is about.
If you make a reservation at a hotel in one of their restaurants, such as Ohana at the Polynesian, or... one of the places on the boardwalk, you can park at that hotel for free. When you come in the gate, they'll scan your band and see you have a reservation at Ohana or...
I didn't even know that.
Wherever. They'll see that you have a reservation and you can go on in and park. So you'll go in and eat, take the monorail to the Magic Kingdom and park there all day instead of paying for parking at the parks. Huge money saver.
Oh yeah, because preferred parking can get up to like $45 a day.
It's outrageous. So, and like if you would make a reservation somewhere at the boardwalk, you could walk to Epcot. You can walk to Hollywood Studios. Mm-hmm. Same with like,
or take a boat.
If you make a reservation at Saratoga Springs,
you can walk to downtown.
You can walk downtown Disney.
Same thing at say Olivia's at Old Key West, because you can walk to downtown.
You can take the boat to downtown.
Yeah, you can take the friendship boats.
Do not park hop as much as you would want to. We park hop every time we go, but we know that we've seen the park so many times that we'll go to Magic for 2 hours, then we'll want to go to Epcot, and then we have a reservation in the Animal Kingdom. So, like, we park hop all day long. But if you and your family are going for the first time,
you're going to want to spend that time in the park.
Why not spend
a whole day.
The whole day looking at the magic?
Especially, I know right now, Disney is doing some sort of kind of deal with one park a day tickets. I think it's as little as $79 per day if you go just to one park per day.
So why not try it?
Which, it's way cheaper than, you know, the alternative.
And again, with saving money with tickets, take one day off and just relax.
and go to Downtown Disney. Downtown Disney is free. It's a lot of shopping. You have to really be dedicated to your budget.
Bring yourself
But they do have a lot of fun things there that are also free, and you can just watch. I mean, you can just watch the Amphicars take off. There's a lot of live music. You can go in and out. Sometimes we just window shop all day long. Yeah. They have free samples of food, especially Ghirardelli.
Yeah.
Oh. You can go into the World of Disney and just look at tons of Disney stuff.
And yeah, like the goofy candy stores, you know, that kind of thing.
Well, your kids might.
And also...
Don't take your kids in there.
Yeah, I'll probably
because I can't even go in there. Also, in meeting characters. The photo pass, when the cast members take your picture, they'll scan it onto your Magic Band and you can decide whether you want to purchase the picture or just let it die. It just goes away. So, with my annual pass, I get a photo pass and photo magic maker, something like that.
Memory maker.
For free. It just comes with my pass. But a great tip that I've seen a lot of people do, and I've heard a lot of people talk about it, is just taking your own pictures on your cell phone. The cast members will, if they're nice. They're nice. Some of them aren't, but most of the time they will take your phone and take the pictures for you on your own cell phone. Or you can take selfies. Cast members and characters love to take selfies. So you just run up and just... The phone's on the floor. Never mind. You'll just
selfie.
Put your phone up with a character and they'll enjoy it either way.
Don't take a selfie stick. They're banned.
Yeah, selfie sticks are banned in Disney.
Moving on for more on the park stuff, especially with when it comes to meeting characters. Especially if you have young kids, you might be enticed into character dining. But that can run pretty steep.
Outrageously expensive.
Sometimes,
one meal at Cinderella Castle, you have to prepay $125.
Yeah, it can get pretty
outrageous.
Pricey. And most of the time, you're probably not going for the food in character dining, you're going for the characters and the experience.
The food's never really all that great. I mean, like, it's really just crappy eggs and bacon.
But you can...
And Mickey waffles.
That's true, Mickey waffles.
You can get those anywhere.
You can meet characters anywhere around the parks at certain times of the day.
For free.
For completely free. And if you have the My Disney Experience app or go on the My Disney Experience website, you can see where the characters are going to be and at what times on what days. So you can do what you're going to pay so much money for character dining, just for free. And have probably a better experience with that character because you have a little bit of time with them instead of they're trying to make it around the entire dining room.
Well, and you can bring coolers full of food.
Which is another way that you can save money. Because when it comes to food, food can rack up really fast. A lot of Disney bloggers or even Disney itself will recommend using the dining plan, but I think that's something that you really have to think about individually for what you need. Because it is a lot of money, but it is a lot of food. So if you are going to eat that much, or if you have a big family, it might in the long run end up being cheaper for you. But say for us, we probably won't eat that much. It's three full
it's just
meals
not,
a day
it's
plus
It's not
snacks.
Worth it for us because what we normally do is we will, I don't know how to start this. Oh! Okay, wait, dining plan.
Yeah.
Currently, what I've been reading up on is that Disney has been offering free or relatively cheaper dining plans to those who will pay in full their hotel. Like, they'll offer you free dining if you'll stay at a moderate instead of a value. So, that's also something to think about, like, spend more money on the hotel, but get all this food for free. And it is literally so much food
for you. But what we like to do is, if we drive, what we'll do is we'll bring food. Disney will allow you to bring food to your resort.
You have a fridge in your hotel room, so...
No matter what kind of room you're staying in, you will have a mini fridge.
You can bring, like, fruit, cold meat, like,
cereal,
condiments,
granola
milk.
Bars... kinds of stuff, that kind of thing. Or if you're flying, and this is something we've done before, I think we used Garden Grocer. It's like an online thing where you can order groceries and they will deliver them to your resort for you. So that can
Which
save
was
you a lot
only,
of money.
We paid like $79 for so
yeah,
much
for
food.
A full week's worth of food. And
honestly, it was delivered to the door. It was literally delivered to us. And we weren't there at the time we were going to pick it up, so they kept it cold in the refrigerator for us.
Yeah, and like, literally, we had so much food that part of it we had to take back home with us because we couldn't eat it all. So that is another really good way to save money on food, because especially, I mean, if you're like me, I'm a foodie. And I love to try new things. If I enter Epcot, I'm prepared to spend a lot of money because I love food. Generally, we'll eat breakfast at the hotel, maybe do a quick service for lunch, and then go out for a sit-down at a sit-down table service restaurant for dinner.
And spend bank.
Which is why you should save before you go, because sometimes you just gotta spend some bank.
Disney will let you bring your own snacks into the park in like little baggies in your backpack, which also brings me to the point where do not spend money on bottled water at Walt Disney World.
Just don't do it. They're like,
bring your own water bottles
a piece.
It's ridiculous.
Don't do it.
Bring a water bottle. They don't usually like it when you would like bring a full water bottle in.
Yeah.
You should fill it inside of the park. They might not let you bring it in.
I mean, just bring an empty water bottle and fill it at the sink in the bathroom if you have to.
There are water fountains around to stay hydrated, but always bring your own water bottles. Don't spend $4 per family member. Water goes so quickly when you're so hot.
It so does. Especially if you're not used to the heat, because we live in Ohio.
We're not used to crap.
We're not used to the heat. We're not used to humidity, so it gets crazy. Share meals with people. I mean,
sometimes.
It might not be the best thing all the time, but if, I mean, say your party, you got some people in your party who aren't all that hungry, but they still want something to eat, you could just get a quick service like chicken tenders and fries and share it instead of each getting like two $8 meals. Like, that's not worth it, you know?
Yeah. Every time my parents go to Le Cellier, they will just both get two soups and then share a steak and a side. Like,
that'll save $50, right?
That'll save you an immense amount of money. And sometimes, like, if we're not feeling like super hungry, like, we'll share like a pizza or like share a sandwich.
Yeah.
Mostly nuggets.
Yeah.
It's mostly nuggets.
But a lot of the restaurants in Downtown Disney aren't necessarily like Disney owned. So some of those things are going to be a lot cheaper than some of the Disney food prices. Like
the Earl of Sandwich.
Like the Earl of Sandwich.
Earl
That's
of
a
sandwich.
Really popular place to go in Downtown Disney. And it's a lot, the fares are a lot cheaper than in Disney owned restaurants because it's not technically on Disney property. And also, we keep saying Downtown Disney, it's Disney Springs now. If you can afford it, which we know not everybody can, try to stay on Disney property. The perks that you get with it and the magical experience that comes with it is totally worth it. And the Valley Resorts go as low as $90 a night.
Under $100 a night.
Yeah, or you can, if you have a camper, you can camp before Wilderness for under $50 a night.
We've actually thought about it.
Couple times.
When we can't seem to afford Disney, that's what we do.
You know, but yeah, if you can afford it, if it's within your budget, try to stay on property. Because you get free transportation. Every hotel, from value to deluxe, whatever, is themed so awesomely. Like, the theming is perfect. It's so great within each and every hotel. Every hotel has a pool. Every hotel has a food court. You know, or someplace for you to get groceries for your room or other stuff like that. So I think the experience is definitely worth it if it's within your budget, for sure.
Also, there are a lot of free things to do at Disney. Like, you wouldn't think there are a lot of free things to do, but they have a lot of free things to do.
They really do.
Such as, you can go to every single hotel for free and just look at them. Look at the gift shops. Look at the pools, check out, they always have like live performers, or at Downtown Disney sometimes they have like it was like a dance recital. The last one I saw was like a dance recital where they had tons of schools when the schools come and perform.
At some of those resorts they'll even show movies at night. The big inflatable blow-up screens, they'll show Disney movies at night, so you can, like...
Those are free?
Yeah. If it's a nice night, you can sit out on the lawn of your resort with all your other resort members and watch Disney movies just to chill out and relax.
If you are staying at a Disney hotel, Disney offers free transportation to the parks, whether it be monorail, Disney buses...
Friendship boats.
Boats.
Ferries.
I think that's it. They offer those for free to all of the parks into Downtown Disney.
If you're staying on property.
Yes. But if I had any advice for anyone, it would be stay on Disney property.
If you can afford it, yeah.
That is like the number one thing that like all of the magic lies within Disney.
Yeah.
If you're not at a Disney hotel, like I don't think it feels nearly as magical. Kills me.
The Valley resorts really are really nice.
If you are staying at a Disney resort or even sometimes off property, most of them will have a pool.
Yeah.
I know all Disney resorts will have a pool.
Every single resort will have a pool with a slide. Yeah. At least one.
So take advantage of having a pool for free. Like even we're staying at Old Key West this time, they have like 5 pools.
Yeah, the big resorts have a lot. We stayed at Saratoga Springs last time, they had like 7.
So take advantage of the pool, skip the water parks. We're skipping the water parks this time, even though I have water parks on my annual pays.
But
if you really decide last minute that you just want to go, like, take a day off of the park and go to the water park instead. It's cheaper.
I mean, they are fun. So it's an experience that you do want to do, but you don't necessarily have to do it every single time.
That's why I think I said a lot of these are based off of personal preference, like whatever your family's most into. Like, mm-hmm. Go with that and leave some of the other stuff for the next trip. You will go again. You will.
I promise.
Also got these super, super cute buttons that we're gonna wear and buy more of before we leave, which I got Ohana Means Family. And we're here for the food.
Probably cheaper than actual Disney buttons.
100%. Yeah. We got the 2 Disney buttons from an Instagram called Try the Gray Stuff, and her Etsy is The Gray Stuff.
We think, at least. And if you're wrong, you have the Instagram. You can look it up yourself.
Boom. I also posted a picture of it on our Instagram, so there it is.
And we'll probably link the actual Etsy store down below so you do know for sure. But I think that pretty much wraps up our Disney on a Budget video for this week. If you guys like it, you know, subscribe, share, like the video, mention us to your friends, share it on Facebook, whatever.
Save
you want to
Disney.
Do. Save money on your Disney trip, home girl.
And you can comment any other ways that you save money at Disney for those who are watching.
Yeah.
They also need to save money, and we do too.
Let everyone else
because
know.
Because we're on #college budget.
#college budget.
So, thank you very much for watching, and
we will see you next time.
Bye!
Bye. Did you just sit down in our frame?
Yes, I did.
Dad, you just sat down in our video.
You can do it outside.
All we have to do is say goodbye!
Sit! No, I'm getting in my chair.